Whoops. Hi there, welcome to the channel, and welcome to the Undernight Inbirth modding primer video. I'm making this video in hopes of making it just a little bit easier for anyone to get into modding this game, and modding as a whole. The capability to mod graphics, stage textures, audio, and most importantly, characters, are just some of the reasons of why you might want to mod this game. Modding Undernight Inbirth 2 is relatively easy, especially if you're open to learning things on your own, and if you have an interest in reading and making documentation. If you've dabbled a little in engines like Mugen, I'm sure you'll be just fine. For this primer, this video aims to be a brief and concise overview on how to set up your folders and workspace environment to be able to hot swap files from the game, and set up a dummy extra character that we can then modify in isolation to the rest of the cast. And depending on how confident and successful you are perfectly able to add even more characters. So, let's get started. The first thing you'd like to do is navigate to your Undernight 2 folder. If you're not sure how to get there, then go to the game in your Steam library, hit Properties, Local Files, Browse. And you might actually want to pin this to your Quick Access directory, if possible. Next, connect to the internet and click the link below, or go to github.com/fati120/undernightinbirth, and you'll be presented with this GitHub repository. This is going to be important for later. But now, ignore everything at the bottom, and look at that green code button. Click the green code button, and then click download zip. You can download it to your folder by clicking the quick access you just pinned, or by copying the path at the top and pasting it into the path here. Once you've downloaded the zip, you can open it right up, open the folder inside, and unpack Uni to Unpacker unless you download it yourself. Here's our real step one. We're going to be unpacking the game files, and I mean a lot of files. Hopefully you have enough disk space, because this game is really uncompressed. If you look at the D directory, you'll see a bunch of gibberish files. These are where the game files are actually held and read from. So to use this tool, we're going to shift right click anywhere in the folder, and you will see a PowerShell window prompt, or command prompt. It might depend on your machine. But for now, let me open PowerShell. You might be able to drag and drop the exe into this window, but for now, let's type /uni2unpacker.exe, and you'll see it tells you how to use this. We want to put the directory of data, or D, and we want an output directory. So we can just press up to bring back uni2unpacker, or type it again, and the data directory is simply D, and you can choose where you want the output directory to be for all the files that you're going to unpack. Now, if you plan on replacing files, you might think it's better to just output all the files in the game's directory. However, I recommend against this, because we should be able to isolate our changes and not get confused later down the line. There are a lot of files, and also if you want to revert your changes or grab a vanilla copy of a file, then you're going to have to output the whole game all over again. So in my preference, we're going to output this to D/output, just hit enter, and you will see the unpacking process go through. I'm canceling that because I've already done it, but as soon as you enter D and you go find your output folder, you will see a lot of files in here. Just for a quick overview, you have your language folders. Battle Res has to do with some story talking stuff. BG is the background data. BGM is background music. Data has all your character files. GRP.dat has some graphics files. Script modifies how the game functions in some aspects. ST is sound effects. Shaders, shaders. And system has some other system definitions. For this video, we want to focus on data, script, and system. You can now close PowerShell, and I would open up another window of your Undernight folder. So how this output folder works is that this all is implied to be in this directory. So for example, if you were to copy this English folder into here, change some of its contents, then those files should apply in game. Now this is where things get a little hazy, but you can actually drag and drop some of these folders into a language folder, and those changes would apply just for that language. Now some of these folders require trial and error on where they can be and where they can't be. Of course, the way to overcome this is via hex editing, but again, we want to make a separate extra character just to get you all set up and used to how things work. Since we are going to create extra data in form of an extra character, we are not replacing vanilla files, so we're able to add a new folder, name it data, go into it, and let's go in here. Now you can choose which character you want to copy. You can find out which character is which by going to one of these language folders, going to system, and opening this file. And you'll see there's a list of characters and what number they are. Enter the data folder, and let's copy character 17. That is Enkidu. Everyone likes Enkidu, so let's just copy him over. Now, you're actually able to use any name. You don't need to use this naming convention that all the other characters have, but for the sake of this, I would recommend a normal numerical name like this. So let's name this folder the next latest number available, 25. Let's go inside. Now you may select all of these and rename them to character 25, just like the folder name. I have bulk rename utility installed, so I'll just use that. If you're familiar with grep or grepwin, then you may use those as well. Anyway, once you're done that, you may now select some of these. We're going to be editing the one called 0, CMD, and MV. So let's look at the 0 file first. So it refers to this as a project name. It's just going to be the name of the folder, so character 25. See, it's referencing the other files that are in this folder, so you can change those to 25 as well. Save that. Here's the command file. These are the definitions for what inputs the character can do. For now, you can ignore all this and ignore this too. You can scroll to the bottom. At the bottom, you'll find this line. See character 17. Let's go for 25. Save that. Go on to the move file. This has all the code. You can read through that. Undernight uses squirrel language. You may go research that if you'd like for more information, but at the bottom you will see character 17 again, set it to 25. Over here, the command table set it to 25. This is a three-letter designation for the character's name. You may use whatever you'd like. I'm going to simply go with AAA, like this. If you'd like while you're here, you can change this as well. Save that. Now, there are these other files here. I'm gonna give you a quick glance. This is just a simple reference file. If you'd like, you can change this too. But all these other files, for the most part, I feel like you can ignore starting out. Sound effect list. You could change this folder more as a category stuff. There's also these you can change to your AAA designation. SE has nothing to change, but it does have some handy details such as the character's HP value. But for now, you're done with this character data folder. You can go back. You can make a new folder now. We'll call it English. It's three underscores, not one, not two. It's three underscores in front of English. Go ahead and enter it. We're going to want a copy of the script folder and the system folder. So script and system. If we go into the script folder, what you want is this battle define character new file. Copy it over. And then you may open this in your text editor. Can cross-reference with this file, the battle defined character table. The new file is just an extension of this one here. As you can see here, this file defines the constants for what characters are allocated to the game. So we're simply going to copy one from each section. One is for the numerical folder ID, and one is for that three-letter ID we made. Make sure these values are set to 25, character folder 25. And this is AAA, and feel free to save that. Next, we want to go to the system folder. You will see this BTL character table or battle character table. Copy that over, open this one up in Notepad. You'll see a lot of Japanese at first, but what we want to look at is this select table array. Now this handles the character select screen slots. So you can see there's two rows. You can see in the middle here, it's 00 and 01. Those are Hyde's and Linnae's slots if you cross-reference. So you might be thinking, oh, well, we can add our character slot now. Just change this to 25. You could, but we want to keep all the slots. So let's just make a new array just like that. You can just add one like this. And let's just fill it in, because if you make the array shorter, then your cursor will be stuck horizontally. Just like that, you have a third row, which will be entirely filled with your new character. Now, if you scroll down, you will see this section filled with a lot of these character number declarations. Copy one of these starting from this declaration up to the close bracket, which has this double comment, and scroll to the bottom. Fit it in here at the end. Here we have character number, set it to 25. Name short, same thing like the folder. That's going to be the name of it. Name long, string master, You can, for the most part, ignore these. They won't be useful right now, but I'll just set it to long just in case. You can set the home stage and the home background music for the character if you'd like. And order is what slot they appear in for things like training mode, etc. So just set it to a higher value, something like 30, maybe even 25, starting from there if you'd prefer. Aside from that, you should be ready. To recap, you copy over a data character folder, rename it, change the variables inside, and make an English folder with 3 underscores, copy scripts battle define character new, fill it in, copy systems battle character table, edit the character select screen and add the character declaration in there. Boot up the game. If you're starting red in training mode, you can actually go over and see that there's another extra slot at the end with an empty name. And would you look at that? Looks like Enkidu, right? Well, you can see that the top left is using an empty graphic, and so is the text on the bottom left that should say EXS. And if you'd like, you can go back to the character select screen. And you will see that if you go out of range, either top or bottom, then there's going to be an extra empty bar. So if you select it, you'll see it's all empty. You can go right ahead and try it out. And you'll see that is a black screen versus screen. That's because we also don't have any graphics there. You can see Enkidu works just fine. It's like nothing ever happened to him, but he is very well a separate slot. And you can see it looks like two different characters. Now, if you have a strange issue, such as a character always seeming to use charge moves no matter how long you hold the button for, then that likely means you did something wrong with the renaming in one of the files. I would stick to trying to use the numbers first, because after you finalize your character and decided who you want to make and what you want to edit, then that'd be a nice time to start editing the folder names. I might as well demonstrate how it looks like if you want to change the character names. We'll change this to Fatty. We'll go here, replace character 25 with Fatty. All done. Once again, we can open all this in Notepad. If you'd like, change all this. For these ones that seem to have a capital, just follow suit and it should be fine. So just like that, capital Fatty. Same thing here. Scroll all the way to the bottom of this one. Fatty move table, Fatty command table. And since we're here, and now we need to go back to the English folder, grab our script, character define new, change this to Fatty. I'm not sure if it's case sensitive, but just follow suit. And now open the game, check out the last section, and we're good. If for some reason you're trying to do it by hand and nothing's working out, then maybe try going ahead and use replace functions. Notepad++ does, for example, have find and files to replace everything you'd like. But as suggested, take your time, and I would start out with using simple numbers and then work your way up from there to rename the character folder. Now, until there's any future updates, you may feel free to go check out the GitHub repo again on how to edit characters, change movesets, the whole shebang. With that in mind though, since we're here, I will decide to show how to hex edit some files so you can edit things like vanilla characters and their original slots, among other things. Now, if you look in your D folder again, you will see all these files, but one in particular we want to edit is called hexe something. And as a pro tip, you're able to type on your keyboard and jump to files. So if it helps, you can start from the top and just type hexe on your keyboard and it should jump right to it. So this file, if we open it in a hex editor, such as HXD or WXM edit, you will see some human readable data, such as these data character folders. So this file tells the game in an absolute way to check these data folders for certain files, and it lists every single file that exists in the folder. So these are all edit and character select folders. So if you scroll a bit past halfway, you will see more familiar files. So how do we get the game to take our edits? Well, the problem is that if you just simply go into the data folder, try to copy a character in and try to make changes, nothing's going to actually happen in the game. What you need to do is to dereference or dummy out the file within this file. Now, before you do anything, make sure you back up this file. This is a tiny file, but it's very important. And if you're starting to have a lot of crashes and you can't figure it out, then you want to have a fallback to rely on instead of using the Steam Verify service. So just make sure you have a copy. Zip it up if you want to be extra careful. And let's look at this. This is a character graphic file. So to dummy it out, let's just click on the text side and just put something like XX. Just anything really that isn't just the same file name. Save that. Let's make our character 000 folder. And let's steal Enkidu's character graphic. And we're going to name this character 000.cg. Now, with that simple edit, just open up the game. And since I'm on trading mode by default with hide, you see this. And what basically happened is we replaced the character graphic files from hide to Enkidu. So that's why everything's all over the place. The palette is surprisingly intact. So by that logic, if you wanted to completely dereference hide, you would have to go through all of these and dummy them out. So in essence, whatever you have changed here to be dummied out, you basically unlock the ability to hot swap the file from within this folder. If you undid all those changes, such as bringing this back to CG, then this will no longer work. And I can show you what I mean earlier. Here we are. So you can clearly see our edited file is still in the folder, but we're back to normal hide. And you can tell the game works like this because even though we had the strange Enkidu sprites going on, you could still see that it was hide's attack patterns. Now this does come with a caveat and I will show you quickly. Let's get rid of this. So if you notice, there's nothing, there's no sprite. So if you understand what's going on, then you'll know that the game does not fall back to the original assets of the game. If it can't find the files in your new dereference location, then it simply doesn't load. Then if you don't have certain files in there, there's a possibility of the game crashing or just acting funny. So in any case, if you wanted to dereference everything, then you would have to go to your output folder, go into data, and copy everything into your own data folder. And if you want to do that, cool. But once again, I strongly recommend that you don't bother with it, especially if you're just trying to make a new character. There's no need to replace an old slot. Extra slots work fine. And that's all, folks. Hopefully this video let you understand a little bit on how to get into Hantei-chan modding, and I think the game has a lot of potential, and I think it's very easy to get started, but it is a very time-consuming task. So far, the relative modding interest is really low, and I'd like to be able to change that. Still, I've been trying to share tools that make the job easier, and I feel like with enough time, something really cool can happen. And again, if you have any questions, please don't be scared to ask me. If you really need to reach out to me, you can contact me on Steam, where I'm open to requests. Use the GitHub tracker, or most actively, meet my homies over at the Guilded server. Whatever suits you best. The aim for the next video is to actually explain how to start making a custom character using several methods, get into a bit of the dirty work on how to start making moves, and maybe share some tips, tricks, and code snippets. Thank you for your viewership, and I'll see you next.